Yes, can you hear me? So today is 31st December, last day of 2021. And our last lecture before first sessional, right? So from Monday you are having a sessional examination. And I think you all have got the schedule and everything, right? Instructions. You all are expert in that now. Online exam. All right, so I'm finding few students. Okay, one more thing is regarding lab submission of online students. Please submit at the earliest. Right? I have changed the deadline from 10 to 8. I have changed it to 8. But most of you have done first, second practical, right? And you have also written it. Then don't wait for 8, right? You have to submit it at the earliest. So submit it before it, okay? All of you, please submit your lab work before the time, right? Don't wait for it. So that if you submit it in next week, we can check, and if there is any suggestions we would like to give, we can provide you. Okay, doesn't matter. You keep it ready. Link will be available soon, and then you have to just upload. It is a 5-minute task. It's just a matter of 5 minutes, right? You just keep everything ready. You just have to submit it so that it will save your time. Okay. All right. So now, starting for today's lecture, today I will discuss Wegener cipher. So, Wegener cipher is one special type of cipher, or we can say it uses addition, right? So, additive cipher. What is the basic idea of the additive cipher? Yes, students. The basic idea of the additive cipher is that you have, so let's say you have plain text character P. You have plain text. So what we do, we use key and generate C, that is cipher text, right? So C is equals to P plus K mod 26, right? Sorry for the poor handwriting because I'm very new to using this tablet pen, so I'm practicing. Maybe soon I will get the comfortable, so that's why I'm sharing with you slides only. But sometimes whenever I re need, I'm using this, or maybe I can use this text. Right. So in Wegener cipher also, what happens? P is P0, P1, P2, P3, and key is equals to K, which is a set. Right? In additive cipher, we have seen that we have taken a key from Z26. How many elements are there in Z26? Right? 0 to 25, right? So any one of that is a key. And one more cipher which we discussed that uses a set of keys, that is which cipher? Which uses set of keys? Auto key. Perfect, Kaushal. So auto key uses set, but even in that, it uses only one random key, and the remaining keys are taken from the plain text. Now here, what happens? And what happens in Playfair cipher? In Playfair cipher, your key is a word, right? And that you put into matrix, right? So here you will find some similarity with additive cipher, auto key cipher, and Playfair Cipher, but there will not be a matrix over here, right? So here there will be key like K0, K1, K2 up to KM minus 1. What is M? What we can say about M? Okay, M is nothing but length of the string, key string. So key is what? A string. Key is what? A string. Okay. So K0, K1, K2 up to KM minus 1 are the characters of the string, right? Characters of the string. We can also say that these keys are like in additive cipher. What we did in additive cipher, we used mapping of characters to numbers. So here also we will use those numbers, right? But here there is not one set. Here there is one set followed by another set. Okay, this second set starts with KM. Okay, and up to 2K2M minus 1. So M to 2M minus 1 is the set which is actually the same as K0 to KM minus 1, right? So KM is mapped to K0, KM plus 1 is mapped to K1, right? Basically, the concept is that whatever key you choose, that is repeated until the plain text is not over, right? So suppose you have plain text of 100 characters. Okay. Suppose the total number of characters are 100 in plain text and you want to encrypt that. Suppose key string is of, let's say, 7 character. Okay. 7 character. So what happens? You have to repeat these 7 characters as a unique key for each character of the plain text until you reach to 100. Are you getting? Have you understood the concept? Yes? Students, can you hear me? Okay, so the basic concept is that if there are 100 characters of the plain text and the key string is of 7 character, right, then how many times we have to repeat this? Yes. Okay, let's wait for the example to come. Okay, so our ciphertext is C0, C1, C2 up to C3. Okay, Kaushal has responded 14 times. 14 into 7 is 14 into 7 is 100 characters, right? So it will start, it will not completely repeat 100 character, but it will repeat only 2 characters in 15th repetition, right? But its repetition is required for 15 times. Is that clear to all of you? Kaushal has given correct answer. Right, so all of you have, understood. So the encryption method is similar. Encryption method is CI is equals to PI plus KI mod M. Why I mod M? I mod M, I equal to 0, M equal to 7, 0 mod 7, that is 0. K k equal to 1 mod 7, so 1. K equal to 2 mod 7, 7. 5 mod 7, 5. 6 mod 7, 6. So k 6, if we put m equal to 7, this k is 6, right? Last key is k 6. So pi plus k 6 mod 26. Okay? So this is how, so it means that the key plain text is going to be encrypted by different keys, not one particular key. It will be encrypted with set of keys. Is that clear to all of you? Okay. Now decryption is similar. Pi is equals to Ci minus Ki mod m mod 26. Okay. Now, this Wegener key stream does not depend on plain text character. It depends only on the position of the characters in the plain text. So let's see example. Right. So this is our key, and key K is Pascal. Pascal contains 6 letters. So what is the position of P in A to Z? If we write like this, suppose suppose let's say we have this A, B, C, D, E. Okay, and for corresponding that we have numbers. Okay, this mapping is there, right? Now we have to find mapping of P. P, right? So 3 and 3, 6, 3, 9, 3, 12, and 3, 15. So 14, right? P's value is 15. It is 16th character. Yes, it is 16th character. So P's value is 15, right? So what we can do is we have to put such values. P is at 15th position. K is at 0th position. Right, S is at 18th position, A is at 2nd position, C is at 2nd position, S 18, A 0, L 11, right? Now we have this plain text and we want to encrypt this, right? So what we have to do, look at the table. See, in this table, we have put this into proper boxes, plain text are into proper boxes. And if we take S, what is the corresponding position of S? S is 18. Okay. We take value from that. Right? S is taken as 18. H is taken as 7. Right? H is 7th character. Sorry, 8th character. H is 8th character. But its value is 7. Okay. Then E is mapped to 4,
eyes have to wait, and so on and so forth. So first we do mapping. For each character of the plain text, we have done mapping of the values. Okay. Next, what we have to do, we have to apply key, or key is Pascal, which has these numbers 15, 0, 18, 2, 0, and 11. So what we do, we replace 15, 0, 18, 2, 0, 11, right? Now what we have done, what we have to do, K0 to KM minus 1, it is followed by KM to K2M minus 1. Now, what is the value of M in this particular case? What is the value of M? 6, right? So, M value is 6. So, last element is? Last element is KM minus 1. So, 6 minus 1, K5, right? K0 to K5. It will start in the next iteration, K6 to K. What will be the value over here? M equal to 6, then 6 into 2, so 12, 12 minus 1, so 11, so K6 to K11, correct? Is that correct? Have you understood this? Right, so first iteration, A equal to, so we have 0 to 5 values, right? So total six, right? So now in the first iteration, we have K0, K1, K2, K3, K4, K5. Once it is over, then we will start with K6, K7, K8, right? Like this. So 15, 0, 11, right? What are the other values? 15, 0, 18, 2, 0, 11. 18, 2, 0, 11. Then we will start K6. Our K6, it is going to be again 15. Okay, K7 is 0. K8 is again 18. Okay, so this way we start. Once the 6 characters are over, then again we start. This way we continue to do this. Okay. So what you can see over here is these key table values are filled like that. 15, 0, 18, 2, 0, 11, 15, 0, 18, 2, 0, 11. Then again, 15, 0. Now there is no more text. So we will not fill the remaining elements. Is that clear? Then we have to perform additive cipher, right? It is additive cipher. So 18 plus 15, what is the value? 18 plus 15? 18 plus 15 mod 26. So that results into 7, right? Seven. Is that clear to all of you? So the answer is H. For first character S, the encryption is H. Now we take second character, which is 7, and its key is 0. So for that also, the encryption is H. So what has happened here is, for these two characters, we have used two different keys. And this way we are taking different keys for each character. And so it is which type of cipher, monoalphabetic or polyalphabetic, which kind of cipher it is? Right, so in monoalphabetic what happens, same key is used for each plain text character. But in this particular case, different keys are used. So it is polyalphabetic kind of cipher, right? So
similarly, so all of these values are then performed with additive cipher, and the result of that is shown in this table HHWKSWX. Okay. For S, it is again S. See, first character is S, it is encrypted to H. Second time S comes, it is encrypted with S. Third time S comes, it is again encrypted with S. Fourth time, there is no S. Okay, so S comes three times. One time it is encrypted with H, and another time it is encrypted with S. This is called as polyalphabetic cipher. Is that clear to all of you? Polyalphabetic? Okay, now see what is happening here is she is listening, right? So which key is used for which character that we are tracing? So for first S, the key is P. Okay, second H, the key is A. Third E, key is S. Fourth I, key is C. Then S, the key is A, and then L, the key is L. Okay. Now what happens again? So if you read this, S, H, E, I is, I S, she is, L, I. Now I again starts from first, right? So we are using this key P for I. Okay, then it is followed by is, she is listening, she is listening, L I S T E N I N G, right? So when G ends, the last key is used, then these are blank, that means there are no characters in this boxes, right? So this key is not used, last four characters of the key are not used. Okay, now let us see the different method. Before that, let us see the possibilities, because Wigner cipher when m equal to 1 becomes additive cipher. So we can say that we are using m additive cipher, right? What is M? Can anyone tell what is M? What is M? Yes, students, what is the M? M is representing what? Let me take the attendance. Okay, so M is length, but which length? So if the questions are asked like this, you have to be specific, right? Which length it is referring. because length could be of plain text, length could be of ciphertext, and length could be of key. So what M is representing? No, it is not plain text length. It is key's length, right? So if you have in a key 6 characters, okay, then you require 6 additive ciphers. So if you are designing a hardware, suppose you are designing a hardware which will perform this cipher operation, because many time what happens, there are specially designed circuits available. The hardware is fast and software is slow, right? So many time it happens that you may require a specially designed circuit which will perform the encryption task. So adder circuit may be used, additive cipher may be used, because here it uses additive cipher uses how many operations, plus and modulo operation. So it, you require M such additive cipher, right? So it is determined by the key length. If the number of key length increases, the requirement for additive cipher may increase, right? So that is the how it should be viewed. So what happens is that in Wegener cipher, if we put M equal to 1, that means key length is of only 1 character, then you have key set K. K equal to K0, that means it is additive cipher. Okay, now if you have M as a key length, then you have K0 to KM minus 1 keys. Now each key can be from Z26. So the total number of possibility for key is 26. Now here there is no restriction that once it is used, second time it cannot be used. And that is why for each key K1, K2, K3 or KM minus 1, the possibility of the character is from Z26 is same. And that is why there are 26 possibilities for each of these key. Is that clear to all of you? And so that's why total number of possible keys are 26 into 26 up to 26 M times. M is the length of the key, right? And so 26 raised to M, that is the length of the key space. Now, if M value is large, then brute force is impossible. Okay. So let us come back to our original one example which we took. Suppose if we have a key length, a plain text of 100 character, okay, then and we have key length of 8 characters, 7 characters which we started, seven character. So what is the key space? What is the key space? What is the key space? Write a number that represents key space. If we use Wegener cipher, have you understood the answer, the question? Well, it is not difficult. M equal to 7, so 26 raised to 7, and you have to perform 26 raised to 7 as the A raised to X method, power function, right? So you have to apply the fast method, or you can use calculator. Now what happens in practice, what happens in application domain, our plain text is usually not of 100 character. For example, your book, textbook, you want to encrypt a textbook, or many times government is preparing certain report, or documents are prepared by the government or agencies. So they have to encrypt those letters, right? So, reports. So these reports are consisting of thousands of words, right? It is not of 100 character text. It is usually in terms of thousands Suppose your textbook, it is consisting of, say, 30,000 words or 30,000, 3 lakh characters or 1 lakh characters. So that is going to be the total size of the plain text. So if you are encrypting for such a huge amount of plain text, then naturally your key length may be little bit higher. For example, if you have 10,000 characters as a plain text, so you can keep key length m equal to, let's say, 100. For 10,000, you can keep k equal to 100. Okay, and then you can apply those keys, or you may keep 26. Even that is huge number. Okay, so that way you may have to repeat it number of times, but that way you are increasing the length of the key space, and the length of the key space is huge, then it will not be possible to break it with brute force method. Are you getting? Okay. Okay, now let us discuss the crypt analysis. Now, what is crypt analysis? Can anyone tell? What do you mean by crypt analysis? See, crypt analysis is basically performed by an attacker to know the key so that the encrypted text can be known, right? Plain text can be generated, right? That is the main goal. So that the main goal is of the crypt analyst is to know the key so that plain text can be generated, right? And for that there are different method, and one of that method is applying all possible keys, that is a brute force technique. But crypt analysis is to know the key so that encrypted text can be decrypted. Is that clear? So not knowing key, it is not possible to know the key, and still you can decrypt it by applying some method. That is crypt analysis, right? In a way, breaking the algorithm, right? And it happens in industry a lot, but there are different reasons for that. So in this particular method, or Vigina cipher, crypt analysis is performed by in two parts. First part is finding the length of the key, and second part is finding the key itself, right? So just imagine yourself to be a crypt analyst, and you have to break the Wigner cipher, right? You want to know the encrypted text. So what will you do? If you want to apply Wigner cipher, then you need key. But key, you cannot guess. One better way to guess the key is once you know the characters, the total number of characters in the key or length of the key, then it becomes easy. Is that clear to all of you? Right? Suppose you don't know the word Pascal. That is a key. But if you know that there is a word of 6 character, then guessing that it could be a Pascal is much easier than not knowing even length of the key. Is that correct, all of you? Have you understood this? If you don't know the length of the key, then key length could be 6, 7, 8, 9, 5, 4, 3, okay, or 10, 11, 12, it could be any. So it is very difficult from not knowing the length of the key to guess the correct key. But if you know the length of the key, if you know the length of the key, then it becomes easy. Or the probability of guessing the correct key increases. We can say that. Is that correct, all of you? Yes, please respond so that I get that you are with me. Okay, got. Good. So first, there are several methods. That means for finding the length of the key, basically you finding means guessing. You have to guess it correctly. If this guess is correct, then this guess is likely to be correct. And for first, there are many different methods, several methods. One such method is Kasinski test. Okay, Kasinski test. So what crypt analysis does? Crypt analysis searches for the repeated text segment. Okay, let me come back to the Wegener cipher and let's have a look at another interesting. Wegener cipher table, right? Let me show you this table. Yes, this one. Okay, so Wegener cipher can also be viewed with table, right? What we have done is, see, there are how many rows? A, B, C, D up to 20, Z up to Z, right? So you have 26 by 26 matrix. In this 26 cross 26 matrix, you are putting A, first position A is first, second position B is first, and you start with B up to Z, and then last character is A. So basically you have shifted A to the last. Okay. Then in third case, the A and B are shifted to last, right? And in fourth case, A, B, C are shifted. In fifth case, A, B, C, D are shifted, right? So if you see eight, it is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, seven characters are shifted. So H, which is eighth character, it starts at the first position. Okay. So this way you have created a table and now you want to encrypt it with Wegener cipher. And our text is, she is listening. Okay. She is listening. Our text is, she is and our key is Pascal. Okay, so our first text is S and its corresponding key is P. Now, if you look at this, if you want to find out its encryption from this table, then you look at S, which is our first character. And which column you have to say, so S row and Pth column, which one is P? This one is P. Okay. So what is S row and Pth column? This is S row and Pth column is H. So you can see it is H. Are you getting this? Right. So H, the next plain text character is H. She, S-H-E, H. Okay. And Pascal, the second character is A. So H is starting with A. Okay. Now, E, right? This one is E, E throw, and C column. So G, PAS, S column, column S. Right, so the encryption is W. Okay. So this way you have to perform whole text encryption with the table. What we have seen is the mathematical model of this Wegener cipher, but the same can also be seen with as the example of the table. Okay. Yes, is this clear to all of you? Keith row, sorry, plain text row, plain text character is the row, and key character is column, and then you have to intersect, and what result you get, that is your ciphertext. Okay, so that is another way of looking it. Now, I was talking about crypt analysis. So in crypt analysis, it searches for repeated text segments of at least three characters in the ciphertext. Why three characters? Because if you write apple, okay, or if you write apple here, so in apple, what happens? P comes two consecutive time, right? So it is possible that in English language, the characters are repeated multiple two times, right? So that the word may contain a character of size 2. That is possible. So to differentiate that the segment is not the word, two consecutive characters of a word, we use at least three characters in the text. So we have to find those segments which are repeated again and again, and the length of that segment should be 3. Suppose that the two of these segments are found and the distance between them is D. What do you mean by the distance? So if you look at this, S, okay, S is at position 0. Okay, in this plain text, the position of first S is 0. Second time when S appeared, okay, that is repeated. Okay, so what is the position of the S? What is the position of the second S? First S position is 0. Not 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Right? So every fourth, assuming that every fourth character is repeated, in this particular case, the text is different. But like if we have to search SHE again and again, it is encrypted, right? It is repeated. Then we have to find all such repetition of SHE, right? But in this particular case, the distance between S, first S and second S is 4, right? So here, the example which you are seeing, let us take another example, okay? Another example, that is ABC, let's say ABC. Then there is some text, and again ABC comes. The distance between them is, let's say, 25 characters. Okay. So the distance is 25. So first time ABC appears and second time ABC appears, what is the distance between them? That is the distance we are referring over here. So suppose that two of the segments are found and the distance between them is d. Is that clear to all of you? Understood? What is distance? Concept of distance? Like in two dimension, the distance is in one dimension, the distance is x2 minus x1. Similarly, here we have x2 minus x1. Right? If we have to find distance on a timeline, right? So the distance is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So the distance is 4, 1, 2, 5. So 5 minus 1, that is 4, right? That is the distance. Okay. Now, the cryptanalyst assumes that d by m, that distance which is found for the repeated segment, that has a relationship, or it can be divided by key length m. So we have to find this d by m. D divides m. M is key length, right? So it is possible that there may be more number of repeated segments. So that means ABC is found, but then there may be after ABC you find CDE, and then you also find CDE. The distance between these two might be, let's say, 28, okay, or let's say 50. It is also possible. So there are different distances also possible. Got it? So if more repeated segments are found with distances, different distances, d1, d2, d3, dn, then what we have to do, we have to take GCD of them, divide by m. Right? So GCD of d1, d2, d3 up to dn. Suppose first distance is 2, second distance is 22. What is the GCD of 2 and 22? What is the GCD of 2 and 22? Yes, students, are you there? What is the GCD? Okay, it's very simple answer, right? So that value we have to take, which divides M. M is the key length. Now, why we assume this? Because this assumption is valid, because if the two characters are same and they are K into M characters apart in the plain text, then they are same and K into M characters apart from the ciphertext. Okay. So what happens? This ABC has a ciphertext. Okay. This ABC, it has a ciphertext, some ciphertext. This is a very important point you to understand. Suppose this ciphertext of this ABC is, let's say, DEF, okay, or XYZ. Let's take simple XYZ. Okay, then what will happen? You are going to analyze ciphertext only. So you are finding segments of XYZ. So if you find repeated segments in the ciphertext, it actually means that the plain text is ABC, or some plain text of three character is repeated in the plain text, right? And the distance between these two and the distance between these two, they are same, right? So this is very obvious, because key is same, right? Because key is repeated. As you have seen, first time Pascal comes, next time again Pascal comes, right? So if this is repeated, it means the distance between these two is the length of the key, right? So our guess that it is length of the key, it is correct. Is that understood? Right? Our guess that it is representing actually a distance. The distance is actually a key length. That is correct. Right? So cryptanalyst uses these segments of at least three characters to avoid the case where the characters in the key are not distinct. That is the example I gave you. Now, there is another concept of index of coincidence. Index of coincidence. What is that index of coincidence? So first we understand the definition. So like what we have done first is that we have applied Karsisky test, and with Karsisky test we find out repeated segment and find out the distance, and that distance gives us length of the key. Okay, now that length of the key is correct, that we want to ensure, for that we use index of coincidence, so that what we assumed, it is correct, right? So the index of coincidence method is used to confirm M value determined by Karsisky test. So whatever Karsisky test has given, it is required to be confirmed, and index of coincidence method is for that. So let us understand the definition for that. So index of coincidence of x is equals to x1, x2 up to xn, which is a string of length n formed by the alphabet a to z. This index of coincidence of string of alphabet is defined as probability that the random elements of x are the same. So in this plain text, some random elements are same, that probability is index of coincidence. And we use this index of coincidence because we are finding this repeated segment in our Karsisky test, right? So the frequency of A, B, C, D up to Z in X are denoted by F0 to F25. You all must have studied this frequency related topic, Hoffman coding, in your DSS course or algorithm course. Do you remember Hoffman coding? Yes? Do you remember Hoffman coding? We used to find frequency of alphabets, right? How many times A occurs? A occurs 26. Okay. What is the frequency of each of this character? What is the frequency of S in this text? Please write down in the chat box. What is the frequency of S? 3. H 1. E 2. I 3. I is 3, right? Then has already come L 1. I already come as come at T. What is the frequency of T? 2. So this way for N we have 2 frequency. So this way we have to find out frequencies. Okay. Frequency of each of these are denoted by F0 to F25. So index of coincidence ICX is equal to sigma FICN, FIC2. FIC2 is NC2. Right? You remember NC2, NCR? NCR. NCR is equals to N factorial upon R factorial into N minus R factorial. Okay? This is the formula of NCR. So it is that NCR which we are talking about. Okay? So here you can see that it is FIC2. So it means FI factorial divided by FI minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial. Now FI factorial can be written as FI into FI minus 1 into FI minus 2 factorial. So FI minus 2 factorial cancels out and it keeps, and 2 into 1 is only 2. And similarly for NC2, you have N into N minus 1 divided by 2. So you have this formula, sigma FI into FI minus 1 divided by N into N minus 1. And so what happens? You have sigma. So this, if this value, if FI minus 1 and FI, if FI is large value, then FI minus 1 is almost same as FI. Right? So we can write like this, FI by N the whole square. FI is the frequency and summation of all frequency divided by N. N is the string of N characters, right? So this is called as index of coincidence. And let me show you one interesting example which is related with this. Or I have already downloaded that. I can show it to you. This index of coincidence. Okay, this is from the URL. I will share this document with you. And this is a very interesting book, The Index of Coincidence in and its in applications in cryptography. And from that, it has this formula which I just discussed that is explained. Now you can see its first example. All of you to go through this example. So in this example, Juarez quote is given on the Kasinski method, right? So this text is divided into 5 characters each. Okay. And then what we have done is that they have used A, B, C up to Z, and frequency of each character is calculated. Okay. And you can see from that, that the percentage of letters in English text that is found is this. And that is the K appears 0.42 times and A appears 8.15 times, or O appears 8%. So we apply this index of coincidence, IC for English, and find the value. So the value which is found is 0.066332. Okay. So for English language, the index of coincidence is 0.0686. And for the text which you have written, for that also the index of coincidence is very near. Right? So we can say that it is for the n value is 26. So it is with this value we have to compare. This is known. Okay? And for our text we have to find this. And then we have to compare these two values. And if it is near to this, it means that length can be 26. Okay, so you go through this. All right, so I stop here for today. And I will share this document with you also. Okay, have a good day.